Western Michigan is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Panthers have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 24-yard line. Out of bounds, around the 27-yard line. That's a 3-yard pickup.
That's a nice completion, but give the defense a lot of credit. They weren't fooled at all. They were able to hold him to a short game.
Throws a bullet over the middle. Brought down around the 37-yard line.
I'm sure the defense thought he came up short. You know, sometimes the officials' judgments can have a big impact on a game.
From their own 37-yard line. First down. And they push him out at the 38. That brings a second down. He's taken down at the 41.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
First and 10, ball on the 41-yard line. Tackle made around the 42-yard line. Stop at the 41-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. On the ground, up the middle. Gets to about the 41-yard line.
Boy, anytime you run the football on third down, you've got to get a better push at the line of scrimmage. That time, the offensive line did not do their job, and the back didn't have anywhere to go.
He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he missed it left. No good.
Well, sometimes when you see a kick like that, the kicker is trying to compensate for a factor, maybe like the wind, and he thinks he can hook it back in. Didn't happen that time.
The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked.
That's a loss of 6 yards. That'll make it second and long.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that.
Number 2 on the tackle at the 35-yard line.
Excellent pass defense. You've got to be able to make a lightning quick reaction to bat the ball away like he did right there.
That makes it fourth and long.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. And this one is a beauty. Brought down at the 26-yard line. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Gets to about the 27-yard line. Second and 9. Ball on the 27-yard line. Fires quickly to the tight end. He's knocked out of bounds at the 42.
Call it a gain of 15 yards. First down.
They bring him down in the backfield.
No gain on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
From their own 42-yard line, 2nd down. Throws it in a hurry. Tackle at about the 37-yard line.
Quarterbacks just love this scenario. He had his man one-on-one on a corner route versus man coverage, and you just saw it. It results in an easy first down.
He gets rid of this one. From the 37-yard line, it's 2nd down. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Downtown.
It can be really difficult to guard these long passes because you got to keep up with the receiver, make sure you don't run over him, and look out for the ball. That was not an easy play.
It's 4th down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Kicks up. He clanks it off the upright. No good. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency.
Ready, set, Lucky 95! Lucky 95!
Uh-huh. Throws middle to the tight end, and down he goes around the 49-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49. Out and he's going to get sacked.
Loss of 3 on the play. That brings up 2nd and 13.
I love the toughness here by this quarterback. Sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
That's a great tackle at the 42-yard line. So at the end of one quarter, no score here. We're ready for more football here in quarter number 2.
Hurry.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick. He's tackled at the 14. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Makes it out to about the 23. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. And he gets a yard on the run. Tackled at the 27-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 27.
Go, go.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 6.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
They'll line it up again on 3rd down. Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run. Booming kick. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Bring him down right around the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line, it's 2nd down.
That makes it 2nd and 8.
Catches it, and that's all. Almost 6 yards on the play action.
Tight end does a good job here of selling his block and then getting out on his route and then making a nice catch for a good game.
Taken down at about the 47-yard line.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
From the 47-yard line, 1st down.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you,
ready,
just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
80. Check, check. Stingray. Stingray.
Gets it out to the wideout, and he's got the first. And he hits him hard at the 29. From the 29-yard line, it's 1st down. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Fires across the middle. He's tackled around the 20-yard line.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
Out of bounds at the 14-yard line. And this is the 8th play of the drive. Makes it to the 12-yard line. Couple of yards there by the tailback on the counter. From the 12-yard line, Second down. After a decent pickup.
Call it a game, 7 yards. Third
down. 10th play of the drive. Finds the tight end for a touchdown.
These guys don't get tense down by the end zone. Sometimes a young quarterback will make a silly mistake or a receiver will come down with a case of stone hands, but not with this group.
So the booth is trying to determine exactly where they'll spot the ball. So they're going to try and determine exactly where the ball was when he went down.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
After review, they'll say that they like the original ball spot. Western Michigan is up by 6. And he hits the PAT. A 10-play, 63-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The score now, 7-0. The Panthers struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game, and sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how he can do. They got to get the ball in his hand somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play, one touch to get this guy going because he has that kind of ability. And up to this point, they've not been able to find a way to get him the ball. Give credit, a lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands of their go-to guy.
And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page. And they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
Zips it to the tight end.
Not that impressive of a play. Let's see if they continue to employ the short passing game or if they decide to run the ball.
Passing situation here, a third and long. Ball on the 30-yard line. He's to the 40. They tackle him there, and he's still going to be short. Gutsy play to try to run for the first. They're just short.
Well, they had a long way to go and figured the defense would be playing pass. So why not try to pull one over him?
Oh, excellent punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. A really defensive battle going on right now so far, Kirk.
Well, the defenses are flying around the football, doing a good job. I think both offenses are making it a little easier because of their style game plan. I think if I were the offensive coordinator, I'd take a few chances. Be willing to open it up and try to give your quarterback a chance to make a play.
Western Michigan is up by a touchdown. He's out to the 30. He gets to about the 41-yard line. Throw to the tight end.
It's all about chipping away at the defense. Even short yardage completions can have a way of building a quarterback's confidence.
It's second and 6. Ball on the 44. And he's going to be sacked. We've played a half of football here. The Broncos with a touchdown lead.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Pittsburgh's first half won't make the season-ending highlight reel, but even so, this team might be behind. But, David, I get the sense they're really not worried.
They should be worried. They're a team that's better. They're equipped to handle this. I mean, we're kind of surprised where it's at. We didn't think that they'd come out and being a significant favorite and being down at the half. But, you know, listen, this happens in sports. The focus sometimes isn't there. Second half, coaches are going to be definitely telling them that they got to pick up the intensity. They got to play better. Are they more talented? Yes. Do they have to show it in the second half? 100%.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Western Michigan up 7 points. Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 25. He's out of bounds, right around the 28-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That makes it 37.
Let's go! Red 18! Red 18!
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. Tackled for a loss.
Number 97. The backfield at the 26-yard line. Fourth down.
Come on, that was terrible. What is that?
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And he's hammered down. So he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
He makes it to the 35-yard line. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He's taken down at the 43-yard line.
Number 8 on the tackle at the 43-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
After a decent run up the gut.
That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Brought down around the 35-yard line. It out to about the 34-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That brings up second and 9.
Second and 9. Ball on the 34.
Mike 51. Hey, let's calm down.
Get
gets it. He's in space. Out of bounds at the 21-yard line.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Setting up the play action. And he's got him again. And this play is number 8 on the drive. It's second and goal, 8 yards out. Makes the catch and look out. He goes out of bounds at the 6. Couple of yards at most on that pass.
This junior wide receiver had absolutely no room to run after the catch. Good play by the defense.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Middle pass, the tight end hauls it in for the score. Tight end scored that time, and with authority.
Brady's a physical football player, but he's also got the finesse to make a big impact in the passing game.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. He makes the PAT. Pittsburgh gets set to kick this one away. He just drills this one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Got his man. Oh, what a hit.
That'll make it second and 4.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
It's our time. It's our time.
Ready! Green 95!
Here's the halfback, and he's brought down hard behind the line.
Loss of 4 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Go with a run, and he's going to be stopped short.
That's a loss of 4 yards of play. That makes it 4th and 12.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. He's taken down at the 37-yard line. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. And they make the stop around the 38-yard line. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. Pushed out of bounds at the 43.
That's a D-19 on the play. That makes it 1st and 10.
From the 43-yard line, 1st down. Throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
And they got him.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
So at the end of the third quarter, we're even at 7 in this one. Back to the action here. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter. Score, and it makes it a one possession game, but we still got a lot of football left. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way.
How about the big fellas up front? This line will have to continue to play like that to build the consistency to help this offense be effective.
From their own 43-yard line. First down.
Here we go. Wide 80. Wide 80.
And he's knocked down immediately after the catch. From the 15-yard line, it's first down. Oh, and he can't hang on. Huge drop there. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
What? What happened?
Third and long here with a vital drive in the fourth quarter, and they need a conversion.
Set, wide 80.
And he's going to come up with a sack. And they get to him again.
Well, this offense is running plays that are taking way too long to develop, giving the defense plenty of time to get after the quarterback. And boy, they're putting a lot of pressure on him.
It's up, and the field goal is good. Western Michigan kicked this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. A score here might effectively end this one. Pittsburgh is up by 4.
takes it to the 41. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 41. He scrambled. They'll bring him down at the 44-yard line. Tackled at about the 45. That makes it to the third down now, and they need to get it inside the 49. Fires right side, got his tailback, and down he goes around the 42-yard line. The Broncos will use their first time out of the half. Just under two to go in the game. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. The Broncos battled all game long, but it's not looking so good right now.
Well, but remember, they're still within striking distance here. If they can put together a drive, they got a shot to win this game.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. And he's taken down around the 20-yard line. He sails it long. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10.
Ready, wide, 80. Wide, 80.
He's at the 30, and he's tackled right away. Got a first and 10. Ball on the 30.
Here we go. Green nine. Huh?
And he's tackled around the 29-yard line. Western Michigan will have one timeout remaining. Left, finding his tailback. He's taken down right around the 20. Under a minute left. And he hits him hard at the 16-yard line. Little toss across the middle. Nice play to set up first and goal. He's scrambling. Touchdown, and they take the lead. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. They didn't snap the ball in time. And he adds the extra point. I wouldn't be surprised if they just squib it here. He sends this one deep. And they can forget about returning this one. Pittsburgh's staff know that they've got a guy in a crucial situation that can maybe make the difference in the ballgame, but you can't just rely on him alone.
Yeah, you got a real difference maker lined up on the outside. The defense knows that. You know they're going to tilt their defense, the secondary especially, towards him. It's going to open up some opportunities for other wide receivers and maybe even running backs out of the backfield to be able to make plays.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Screen pass incomplete.
Can't blame him for not hanging on to that pass. He got hit pretty hard.
It's third and long, and at this stage of this game, they probably have to go to the air. Tackles him hard at the 36. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
The Panthers are going to call their second timeout. Only 3 yards there on the throw.
That's a nice catch by the junior wide receiver, but an even better effort by the defense to keep him from going anywhere.
Throws it in a hurry. Brought down at the 50.
That's a smart play here by the quarterback. He threw it into the window the zone coverage gave him. Nice pass and a nice job by the receiver running a slant.
One last play, folks. It's time to find out how far he can throw it and see if this game becomes one of the all-time greatest. Here we go. He airs it out. Dropped. Panthers have to look at this somehow as a positive. Their star player had a great game. They just got to look the next week.
Yeah, it's tough anytime you lose a game to be positive, but if there is anything to be positive about, it's about that performance by this individual. He really did everything that he could do to try to win this football game. Unfortunately, the team ends up losing, but they can build to the future around his abilities for sure.